Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Oxhorn, and today I'm here with a special video on some of the best downtown Boston city player homes. Not all of these are in Boston. I guess I should say some of the best city player homes. This is a companion video to my hermit player homes video that I published a week or so ago. This is going to be a series of mods that give you beautiful homes in urban environments. The tops of skyscrapers, ruined apartment buildings, and the like. These mods are all available on the PC, and many of them have console versions as well. So if you want it for the Xbox or for your console, please check out the description of this video where I include links where you can download them for your console if they exist. I'm here by the Dartmouth Professional Building to show you the first one on the list today, which is The Top Floor by Quaz30. Now, the mod description doesn't actually tell you where the top floor is, so I had to do some hunting, but I found it finally. It's here at the Dartmouth Professional Building. Now, the thing is, this is a hotspot of activity. As you can see, I had quite a battle out here when I first arrived. I had to fight some raiders, there was an entire gang of rust devils, but once dead, I'm able to enter the building, and once you discover it, a fast travel marker appears on your map with a direct link there, so there's the Dartmouth Professional Building, and then there's the Dartmouth Penthouse. But let me show you how to get into it. So this door right here takes you to the Professional Building, and this is the new door, which includes an elevator, which takes you to the penthouses. And this is probably my favorite part of this player home. The entrance here is really well done. Look at this. We've got a cracked open window, light streaming in. Look at the wind blowing leaves through the gaps in the glass, and look at that paper and that cloth flapping in the breeze. That's so well done, and it's so interesting, and look at this poor chap. Oh! Whoa! This is a glitch with skeletons in the game. I don't know if you've noticed it, but every now and then, some of the bones will start to articulate themselves. It looks like this guy's head is... Oh! And he's looking right at me. Alright, buddy, are you done? Yeah, that's not creepy as all get out. Well, apparently the skeletons in this player home are haunted. But look at that view out that window. Wow, we are at top of the world here. And same over here. That looks south towards downtown Boston proper. There's the Mass Fusion building. Anyway, let's head on upstairs to show off the way this thing looks. I should have closed this. I came by earlier to check it out. Anyway, this is what you see. You see these three doors. On the right here is the door to the jacuzzi. You can't use the jacuzzi. It's just for show. You can drink the water if you want. But it's got this nice like submarine window, this port window with a beautiful view into the northern wasteland. And look at the light coming in. Oh, look at that. The shadow it casts around the outside and the glare from the light is just breathtaking. And so this is a functional bathroom, complete with a sink that has running water. So this room is nice, it's beautiful, it's just for show. But over here, this is actually a power armor stand. These American flags are power armor stations, which I think is pretty clever. You rarely find... I mean, this is a unique way to tackle the whole power armor station situation, because they usually take up so much room. So just coming in here, park your power armor right on top of there. Touch the American flag to access your crafting menu, and there you go. You can now work on your power armor. Pretty cool. But we should head on to the loft proper. And there it is. It's just gorgeous in here. Look at these slanted windows. Look at those slanted windows. They just let in so much light, and they give you a beautiful view of the surrounds. The top of this building wasn't used really by anything, so this is a welcome change. And look, we're looking north, I guess we're looking. Yeah, because this is the Dartmouth Professional Building. There's Bunker Hill. So yeah, this is a view north. And oh yeah, there's Diamond City, right above Diamond City. So you kind of get an idea of where we are here. It's a great location for a player home. And here is a pool that does work. So you can get in the pool. I'm not sure the lore reason behind the waterfall in the main living area here. Probably gonna get humid, but it sure looks great. And I'm not complaining. Lots of wonderful decorations. This is one of the things I wanted to make sure that most of the mods I went over today were move-in ready. Only a few are not. Most of them are move-in ready. And then check this out. I just finished my video on all the cars of Fallout 4. There's the Rocket 69. There's the Chrysler Corvega. And then he's got an ATV and a tank on the wall there, which is pretty cool. Lots of books and mini nukes, wonderful decorations on the wall. And then this is your bed, right? That's pretty great. What a beautiful view to wake up to in the morning. Just look at the time and attention and effort that went into every little detail here. You can sit down on your bed. Is that a Liberty Prime? Look at that. You've got your own little miniature Liberty Prime on your bedstand, which is pretty great. Here's your office. You've got a terminal to play your holotapes with. Wonderful storage over here. And here, look, a magazine rack. You can put all of your astoundingly awesome tales in there. Around here, we've got a pool table. Let's see. Oh, that's so cool. Yeah, he took a little refrigerator and turned it into a cooler. And it's functional. It opens right up. Radio, a pool table for entertaining guests, and then more. Looks like this is all just decorations. Let's see. Yeah, there's some storage. So here's an alcohol storage area for your wet bar. This is a functional stereo, which tunes into Diamond City Radio. And then a TV with some sitting over here. Oh, that's an interesting TV. I don't believe that. Yeah, I don't think I've seen this in the vanilla game. That's new. So there's a Radiation King TV. Pretty cool. So he does have plans for this mod. This back door, for example, doesn't work yet. He has plans to open this up to roof access where you could do building. And also a storage area, but he hasn't built that yet, so that's non-functional. But on the wall here, we do have some weapon racks, long weapon racks there, where you can put some weapons. So pretty doggone cool, beautiful little area. There's no workshop access right now, and I'm not seeing a lot of crafting stations. I did take a tour of this earlier, and I didn't see any. You'd think if there was a cooking station that it would be right here. But we just have that cooler. So this is really just a beautiful place to store your belongings, and you might need to find another place to actually do your work, to craft your items and repair your equipment, with the exception of the power armor station, which is right in here. Again, the mod author does have plans to expand it out the front there, where I'm sure you'll be able to access some more crafting stations. But this is what we have at the moment, and it is beautiful. What a great little addition to living in downtown Boston by Quaz30. Thank you very much, Quaz30. Next up is Shesri's Loft by Shesri. And here we are at the Cabot House. There's the Cabot House right there. And you're gonna see this location as a popular one today. There are a few player home mods in this location. And this one opens up a new door right here to the left of the entrance of the Cabot House. And it simply says apartment. You get a new fast travel location called Louisburg Square Apartments. So these apparently are the Louisburg Square Apartments. Let's head on in. And this mod is just so pleasing to me because it just does exactly what it says on the tin. It's move-in ready, it's beautiful, it's functional, it's just so great. So this mod author put so much attention to details, with all of the little containers. This acts as a container. This is your drinks cabinet. You can store all of your alcoholic beverages. This is your key container. And this is the primary living room. Look at the light coming in through those windows. This is a feature of some of my favorite mods. Let me turn off my torch there. Look at that. The light coming in through the window is just gorgeous. We've got accent lights up there to light up your ferns. Here's your bobblehead stand. We've got some chest of drawers over there. More chest of drawers over there. And then here's your place for entertaining. A wonderful little living area with lots of modern art on the walls. Around the corner here, this is going to be your kitchen, complete with a bar and bar stools. So maybe you and your companions can get up in the morning and have a bite to eat. This is a working sink. Turn on with flowing water. And here is your cooking station. At least, there it is. Cooking stove. So you can use this to craft your food. And it is perfectly functional. Over here, we've got your pantry. Each of these is a container. So there's a dirty water container, a purified water container. If you really want to get OCD about it, you can organize all your spare foodstuffs by category. You've got your produce over here, packaged goods over here, because this mod author has given you a container for each of them. We've got a fridge door, and inside we've got containers for all of the different kinds of foods that you need to refrigerate. So you could put all of your cooked meats in the cooked meat container, which is pretty cool. And then this is the primary bathroom. Mirror on the wall, working sink, and a place to sit. All right, let's head on upstairs. We've got a jukebox, one nice big magazine rack over here, more modern art on the hallway walls, and door number one leads to your bedroom. We've got this retro mustard yellow color scheme going on here with the covers and the drapes. Look at these wonderful windows letting in all that beautiful light. And then this is going to be your private bathroom. It's a little bit larger than the guest bathroom, but it has many of the same amenities, including a place to sit, and it does work. Oh man, I feel so relaxed right now. Alright. Shower. Sink. Perfect. Heading on out, we've got clothes storage in there. All of these nicely labeled. This little nightstand actually works as a container as well. You get a free pair of eyeglasses out of the deal. Cool, can't say no to that. So there you go. There's your master bedroom. Coming around the corner here, we have the laundry room. So this is where you can keep all of your spare clothes, washing machine, and a dryer. Both that work as functional containers. And then let's head upstairs to the workshop. This is where the primary workstations are. We've got an armor workbench. Sadly, none of these are connected. I tried testing it earlier. I put something in this one, I think. Yeah, I put a plasma grenade in there, and sadly, it's not connected to any of these. So that's a bit of a bummer. In my opinion, if the workbenches aren't connected, if they don't share inventory, that makes it an inferior choice to a workshop, just going to a settlement and creating your own settlement there. But for many people, that's not a big issue, so this is going to be wonderful for those of you. And then I love the way this mod author organized storage. We have a variety of different colored suitcases, and look, every type of ammunition in the game nicely organized by ammo container over there. We've got more. Look at this. This is for all of the energy weapons, all of the energy ammo. Mini nukes, Molotov cocktails. Look here, you can organize all your chems from Daddy-O to Med-X. Looking pretty great. More big trunks for all of your organization needs. And then here are some even more chems and medical supplies for you to store your items in. So, just a lot of attention to detail that went into this. It's really well done, and it just works. Now, many of you might have noticed, hey, wait a minute, I saw every single workstation except the power armor station, and I actually missed this my first time, but you come downstairs and around the corner, and here it is. This is your power armor workstation. Again, it doesn't connect inventory with the others, but you can store all of your belongings there, maybe even some junk that you use to repair your power armor. The reason I missed it the first time is because when you come in through the door there, it plops you right here. You're staring right at the stairs, and you have to turn and go, oh yeah, that's right there. So there you go, a wonderful little player home mod right next to the Cabot House. Fully nav meshed, as you can see, my companions are chilling out and having a great time. So thank you very much, Shesri. Here we are back at the Dartmouth Professional Building to show off my next mod, which is Back Bay Penthouse by Calorand. So remember in the first one I talked about where I said that the mod author had plans to open up the back to allow rooftop access? Well, if you just can't wait, this mod is for you. It allows you to build in full workshop mode on the roof of the Dartmouth Professional Building. And at the moment, I'm thinking that it probably would be compatible with the top floor loft, because if you recall, when we installed the first mod, a new door opened up here that brought you to the loft. This is the original door that came with the Dartmouth Professional Building. And then the Back Bay Penthouse actually opens up a new door here to the side, which leads up to the penthouse. And here we are. We're on top of the Dartmouth Professional Building. This is the entrance right there, this little hatch that leads back down, so you don't actually get to watch yourself riding an elevator. But the fast travel location marker leads you right to the rooftop. So if you want, you don't have to go through that door every single time you want to access your new apartment. Now, you will notice that nothing is built up here. I wanted to really show off move-in ready mods, but I just simply couldn't talk about downtown Boston player homes without talking about this mod, because this is so cool. Look how he did the workshop. He built the workshop into the side of this little lip on the roof to take up as little space as possible. When you activate it, you have access to full workshop mode. Now, I can't build anything because I have nothing here. And I don't believe you can connect your supply line here. But if you brought all of your materials down to this workshop, you could build any structure you want. Look, I have access to the shack build menu, to the metal shack build menu. Here's the concrete tile set. Here's the warehouse tile set, the wooden barn tile set. I can even build a vault up here. You have access to everything, which gives you an enormous amount of freedom. So no, this is not move-in ready, but look at this. You are on top of the world. The only building taller than this one is the Mass Fusion building over there. You're really at the top of everything. As we saw in the last video on the top floor loft, you have a beautiful view of downtown Boston, including Diamond City, and upwards into Bunker Hill. Yeah, there's Bunker Hill over there. So, a really cool little addition, and it comes with this pool. Now, the entire top floor is nav meshed, with the exception of this pool. He only has the shallow portion right here nav meshed, because if your companions go swimming, sometimes the geometry glitches and they'll fall, they'll clip through the siding, the side railing here, and then fall to their deaths, which we want to avoid. So they kind of wade in the shallows, they don't go swimming. But aside from that, it is completely nav-meshed. So I didn't take the time to actually build anything huge up here, I just wanted to show off the Back Bay Penthouse by Caloran77. Alright, looks like Preston fell to his death and then teleported up to the top here somehow. So yeah, some issues with companions, but what do you expect? You're on top of the world here. Anyway, a wonderful mod. Thank you very much, Calorand. Here we are back at the Cabot House for the next mod on the list, which is called Cabot Square Apartments by Borjoy Z. Chesri's loft was over here. I uninstalled it now. And Borjoy Z's mod opens. To get to the player home, we first have to navigate through this series of ruined apartments, and looks like I need to get in there, Preston. So, this is a locked door, which is strange, because I can see right in it, and I could probably reach around and just unlock it from the other side, but it's a locked door, so let's go ahead and unlock this. Now, what we're doing right now is we're trying to find a key to the apartment complex. This is not the apartment. What we're looking in now is just a dungeon that comes with the apartment. Instead, we've got to find a key that will let us into the real apartment. Lots of wonderful attention to detail placed around here. It just looks like a dilapidated place. All of this is handmade by the mod author. None of it came with the game. All right, let's go upstairs. Now, we've got to find a key. And it's not in that duffel bag. Let's see if we can find a way around. Oh! And the door opens on its own. So, let's move on upstairs. And here we go. So this is a storage facility with a bunch of scrap and junk that you can find in there. Apparently the ghouls are hiding. I killed the ghouls earlier, and apparently when I reloaded the save, it didn't cause them to regenerate. But here's how you find the key. So at the top of the elevator shaft, there's the call button. You gotta drop down to this part of the elevator, open the hatch, drop down here, and inside is a hanging duffel bag with the apartment key. We can now open this bottom door, which is where it leaves us where we were at the beginning, and apparently Preston is still stuck up there. Then we can retrace our footsteps, go all the way back, but instead climb the stairs. Again, normally we would be being attacked by a bunch of ghouls right now, but apparently when I killed them the last time I came through here, the game remembered that and it didn't respawn them, so no ghouls to show you today. Anyway, here we go, onto the apartment. Coming out that door dumps us here into this little patio on the rooftops here, which is kind of nice. And the actual apartment, the player home, is right here. The apartments. It opens up a fast travel location. You have to find it first. The Cabot Square roof. That's now the fast travel location that'll take you to your new player home. And here we are. This is the player home. It's decorated up really nicely, like like a home that you found sitting after 200 years would be. So it's not as beautiful and well put together like all of the others, but it is also a functioning workshop. This is going to be your power source. The fuse box produces 100 power, so you can wire everything to that. And it is already decorated. It's move-in ready with all of the necessities that you need. But if you don't like the simple decor that he has for you, you can go ahead and make your own. But that's not even the coolest thing about this player home. Let's continue exploring. It is very large. It's a very large player home. This is the bedroom. You're going to want to scrap that and replace it with something else. And then let's head on downstairs because this keeps going and going and going. Here's the second floor. And the cool thing about this is there's a bit of a story that comes with this mod. So if you don't want spoilers for this mod, maybe stop watching. But the story goes that the person who founded this house was a disgruntled former Institute employee who was responsible for doing the research on the relay. He leaves the Institute, builds his home here, and builds his own relay. But this is an interesting relay. Let me show you how it works. Here's Professor Tyrell's terminal. Go to the terminal. And you can read all of the journal entries which tell you the story of how he got here. But what we want is the holotape. So let's eject the holotape. And this holotape is called Holotape Portable Relay, and it gives us the instructions we need to use this relay. I'll show you how that works in a minute, but first let's continue exploring this player home. Remember that we have access to the workshop at absolutely every moment. So here I am at the basement, and you can see that it's nasty and there are bodies, there's even a dead Brahmin. But look, it can be scrapped. So you can take care of all of this and make it much more beautiful if you want to. There's a cage with a button over here. A body on a mattress. Apparently he used to cage up people. So, it's just a great place to start your creative process. But let me talk about the molecular relay. So, the way it works is it gives you a to and from location, and it even works in dungeons. So, let's do a real life scenario. I'm gonna fast travel out of here and go to some location in the Commonwealth, and then I'll show you how this works. Alright, so here I am in the Shaw High School, and let's pretend like I've been going through this dungeon. Oh. Alright, so let's no longer pretend. Let's say, hey, I have been going through this dungeon. And I've been killing super mutants. Alright, super mutant down. Ah, man. Always when I'm in the middle of recording. Right, alright. Done. So, now I can show you the rest of this mod. So, I've been clearing out this dungeon, and let's say I'm encumbered. Oh man, I'm in the middle of the dungeon, I don't want to drop anything. Tell you what, let's use the holotape that we just got out of that terminal. Holotape portable relay. And then, let's choose the home location. Alright, coordinates accepted. Let's exit our Pip-Boy. And here we are. We're back at our relay in the middle of our new player home. So I can go to my crafting chemistry station. I can drop off all my junk. And then let's say I want to get right back into the fight. Just come over here, press this red button. And that sends me right back to where I was. The last location that I was at is where it sends me back to. And then I can continue on clearing this dungeon. So, what a cool little mod. It's not just a player home. It comes with practical, useful stuff that you can use in your everyday playthrough, and it comes with a little dungeon attached to it. It's such a well-done player home, and it's so much fun. So thank you for that Boar Joy Z, wonderful mod, and I link to it in the description of this video. Last on our list today is Boston Common Loft by Quaz30. This mod gives you this whole building right here in downtown Boston with all these wonderful bronze sculptures on the outside. It's quite a beautiful building. Looks like we've got ourselves a red Chrysler Corvega ready for the move. So, we just moved into our brand new apartment. Let's go check it out. So here we are. This is the interior of the apartment complex. Let's turn on our light because it can get pretty dark. And man, looks like this guy blew his brains out and everything. Goodbye, darling. I just can't. I can't. Everybody, oh, that's just horrible. Lots of swearing. Terminals, and just don't start. I miss you every day. It's a sad story, ladies and gentlemen, that came with this particular mod. Anyway, so this is the lobby of the apartment complex. We've got some chems on the ground. This apparently is the apartment manager with keys on the wall, perpetually guarding his post. And then this elevator leads us on up to the new home. Do, 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 do. And here we are. Look at this place. So, chandelier hanging from the ceiling, beautiful light coming in from the walls, and then this guy comes with a nice note. Hello, smiley face. This is your new home. You can decorate it any way you want. Thank you very much, Quaz. So just hold V, and that will bring up the settlement crafting menu. And from here, you can scrap whatever you want, including the doors. It has a number of different rooms, and just, you know, note this has not been decorated. There we go. There's the workshop. This has not been decorated. One of the few ones that is not move-in ready. But I wanted to include it because it is in the middle of downtown. So it's a central location, exactly where we wanted it to be. And it has just infinite potential. You have so much room for anything you want. All of these different rooms that you can completely build. Even down in the lobby area, you can build and you can scrap. Also, it's got this really cool feature. Let me show you. It's got a very tiny balcony. And very tiny. You can't build out here or anything like that, but we've got a tiny balcony with a wonderful view of downtown Boston. There's Mass Fusion, there's the ship in the skyscraper, looking on down here. Oh, better be careful. Don't want to fall on off, that would be bad. But there's your red car that you just moved into, and here you're at the very top of this nice little building. So it's not quite as tall as the Dartmouth building or some of the others we've looked at, but it does have a wonderful view. And I just love what he has done with the light here. You look at all of these wonderful windows with light shining down right on this guy here. And I believe that all of this is scrappable, so it's not like you're going to be stuck with a skeleton for your entire playthrough. So no need to worry about that. And if you don't like having this dilapidated lobby with three corpses and a bunch of stuff, I believe the workshop works down in the lobby as well. So just head on down the elevator, open up workshop mode, and then scrap skeletons and trash and rubbish to your heart's content. What is this? Is that a waterfall? What? Apparently there's a waterfall coming out of your computer. Oh, I see. Okay, so there was like a bathtub up there, and it started leaking. There's the water. The water is coming through the pipe and then cascading down. I see. So one of your neighbors 200 years ago is having a sink issue, and so there's flooding down here. But yeah, it does work down here. You can clean this up if you want to. So thank you very much for your wonderful mod, Quaz. And there you go, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you liked this video. I had a lot of fun going through these player homes for you. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like me to go over some other player homes. We did hermit player homes, I've done ship player homes, I've done boat player homes. Let me know what kind of player homes you would like to see in my next video, so subscribe for more of that. I do videos on a wide range of topics besides just mods and player homes, including Fallout lore, etc. So please subscribe to find more of that content. And if you like what I do and you want to support me in a more personal way, what is going on here? We've got a random iBot, ladies and gentlemen. If you want to support me in a more personal way, consider becoming one of my patrons on Patreon. Patreon subscribers gain access to my private Discord server, as well as a bunch of other cool Oxhorn perks. Oh man, we got dogs. And a glowing dog. Alright, dog meat, you can finish him off. How about that? Or not. Leave it to me. That's fine. I'll take care of it. But you know what, ladies and gentlemen, even if you do not want to become a Patreon subscriber, that's okay. I am just so very glad that you are here watching this video. So thank you so much for watching, and tune in tomorrow morning for a brand new video. I do a new video every single day of the week. I'll see you tomorrow morning, bright and early, with a brand new video. What?